Well, we want to begin this morning with a deadly brawl in Melbourne. A major investigation underway after a scuffle between residents and a suspected thief left a man dead.
Today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn is at the scene for us this morning. Chris, you've been speaking to locals there.
I have, Sarah, and understandably, they're pretty shaken up by what happened here in Hoffland Drive, Craigiburn. Yesterday afternoon at about 2:30, police say that a man was trying to break into a car. Residents have confronted him and a fight has broken out. Paramedics and police, they did arrive on scene shortly after. As that man was being arrested, he became unresponsive. He was treated by paramedics but died here at the scene. Here's what Cheryl, a resident of this street for 26 years, had to tell me.
Anything's possible in Craigiburn, but then you hear all these rumours, so you don't know who to believe or what. Until the investigation's finished, we'll know the final truth.
I'll just give you a look at the scene this morning. It was completely taped off by police well into the night until about 11 o'clock. As you can see, it has now been cleared. But that blue car that the man was found, was died next to, remains here, Sarah, as the homicide detectives continue their investigation.
Thank you, Chris.
Turning to a developing story out of regional Queensland now, an emergency search and rescue operation is right now underway for two missing miners after a collapse at a zinc mining site. The incident happened near Clonbury, an hour outside of Mount Isa. Underground drones are now being used to find the two men who are believed to be buried 25 metres deep. Let's bring in Today Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers with more details. Andrea, this is going to be a complex mission.
Yeah, Brooke, keeping in mind that whilst they're believed to be 25 metres deep from where they dropped, this is an underground mine, so they're actually believed to be 125 metres under the surface of the ground there. So they have used underground drones. What they have found is the exact location of where that ute is that is believed to have those two miners inside it. Any attempts to make radio contact with them have so far failed. This frantic search all triggered after the ground beneath a 30-ton drilling rig collapsed, taking with it the rig as well as this vehicle. Now, the operator of that drilling rig did manage to escape.
The drill rig operator has been rescued and has received medical attention and is in a stable condition. We know the location of where the incident has occurred. The two missing people are approximately 125 metres below the surface.
Rescues have worked through the night. Grave fears are held for those two miners.
OK, thanks, Andrea. A woman has this morning been charged after a 14-year-old boy was killed when he was hit by a bus in Sydney's southwest. The incident unfolded outside MacArthur Anglican School in Cobbetty yesterday afternoon. The 54-year-old will face court today. The Australian Navy is bracing for a surge in asylum seeker boats amid changes to the refugee visa system. In response, the Navy is providing extra surveillance support in Australia's northern waters. International security expert Professor John Blaxland spoke to Today on Nine a short while ago.
Australia's surveillance system is pretty sophisticated, so there'll be some telltale indicators that they're picking up in the region that the network of people smugglers are actually gearing up, and I think this is what this is in response to.
The opposition has warned the changes to the visa system could prompt a resumption of people smuggling.
Millions of Aussie mortgage holders are feeling the pressure this morning after RBA Governor Philip Lowe conceded there is no end in sight for future rate rises.
We want to get inflation down because it's dangerous. It's corrosive, it hurts people, it damages income inequality, and if it stays high, it leads to higher interest rates.
The cash rate has risen from 0.1% to 3.35% in just 9 months. And as Australians struggle to pay their bills, there's this admission from the Commonwealth Bank. It's making $1 million in profit every single hour. Gabrielle Boyle joins us now live from Parramatta. Gabby, how are people reacting?
Carl, there is no doubt that if with every interest rate rise, the anxiety level of mortgage holders rises alongside it. Here on the streets of Parramatta, it is certainly front of mind for many people. But the reality is many of the folks we spoke to this morning can't even get a mortgage. It is a pipe dream. They are living week by week, really struggling to make ends meet. Let's hear from them. What's made you decide to keep renting?
Just a sheer cost of house prices and mortgage rates going up.
It's too expensive to get a home loan.
There's just no incentive to own a home.
I have got three home loans.
And are these interest rate rises making you sweat?
No, because I fixed them during 2022, so they're fixed and they can't change until next year.
I rent.
Are you glad you don't have a home loan at the moment?
At this stage, yes.
One of the biggest challenges people spoke about, Carl, getting that deposit together to take out a home loan in the first place. For most people, though, the real worry is not how to save for that deposit, but how to pay the bills, how to pay the electricity, how to pay the rent, and how to put food on the table.
Spot on, Gabby. Thank you.
The Scottish independence movement has had a setback, with the woman at its forefront stepping down from the country's top job. Jess Millwood is in London for us. Jess, Nicola Sturgeon has bowed out at a critical moment.
Morning, Sarah. She has, but she says that she has made the decision to resign out of duty and love for her country, her party and the independence movement that she has dedicated her life to. Nicola Sturgeon has been under pressure lately over gender equality reform, also an ailing health system, and some people in her party were upset that she was deciding to move forward to the next election on a platform of it being a de facto referendum for independence. But she says despite all of that, she has been considering stepping down for many weeks, and her decision is based on much more than short-term pressures.
Is me carrying on right for the country, for my party, and for the independence cause I have devoted my life to?
And ultimately, the answer to that question was no. There is no obvious successor for Nicola Sturgeon, but a new leader will be decided in the coming weeks. This will be a big blow for the independence movement in Scotland. Sarah?
Thank you, Jess.
China has threatened to take countermeasures against the US over a takedown of a suspected Chinese spy balloon in American airspace. The Chinese Foreign Ministry says they would target relevant US entities that undermine China's sovereignty and security. An earthquake has rocked parts of New Zealand as the country grapples with the aftermath of Cyclone Gabrielle. The 6.3 magnitude quake struck near Wellington at around 8 o'clock local time last night, with no reports of injuries. Meantime, the death toll from the cyclone has risen to 5 this morning. Now to a Today weather alert. Heatwave warnings have been issued in several states, with some areas potentially reaching 50 degrees. Isabella Staszkowski joins us from St Kilda in Melbourne. Isa, good morning to you. How's it feeling there at the moment?
Brooke, for anyone waking up in Melbourne this morning, if you need to get something done today, do it now. It is a beautiful 22 degrees right now, but it is going to get pretty hot throughout the day. There's an extreme heat warning here in Melbourne until about 9 o'clock at night, and tomorrow it is going to get hot again. Around 35 in Melbourne, so it won't feel too bad. But over in Mildura in regional Victoria, it's expected to get to about 41 degrees. Most of the country today does have that heat wave warning. In northern WA, it could get to about 50 degrees at some point this week. The state actually recorded our hottest February temperature ever in 1998, 50.5 degrees. There are a number of safety warnings, of course, in place due to all of that weather. A fire danger warning, of course, today after a number of significant fires in Victoria over the past couple of days. There's also a warning, of course, for people to take extra care around bodies of water after two people drowned near Mallacoota yesterday. So hopefully it is not a busy day for authorities. Hopefully it's just a day where people can have an early knock-off and enjoy some of that heat.
I reckon that sounds like a good idea. Thanks, Izzah.